Carlton on the break. Wiggins. Fevola one out. Good hands against Michael.
Now he'll have a shot, but Lance Whitnell has just come on at the 29-minute mark of the second quarter, and you'd wonder why. Why keep him on the interchange for 29 minutes?
Fevola goalless so far. Has kicked two behinds. A couple of other attempts haven't been that successful. From outside 50, launches this, and finally he's made good contact. He kicks his first.
So Bentick sweeps it forward off. Fevola can kick a second here. He drives it low and hard. Another one for the Blues. Fevola's kicked two in 2 minutes. And given the Blues some hope as they narrow the margin back to an even 6 goal.
Back from him. And delivers perfectly to Fevola. What a turnaround. 7 or 8 minutes before halftime, you could not have imagined this. Ryan Houlihan, indefatigable in his midfield role.
Carlton have never come back from facing a deficit of 48 points in their history to win a game of football.
Came back from 44 one day in a big final at the MCG. Fevola has cut the margin to just 13 points. Fair enough. Carlton on the breakaway. Carrazzo delivers to Fevola, who will line up again. And all of a sudden, he's found the range. Well, it's not really consistent with the way in which the rule has been interpreted over the last 2 weekends, you'd have to say.
Highly consistent with what we saw in round one, though.
Yeah, but that is ridiculous. That's not a free kick. The Essendon player, how can he possibly get rid of it? It's the most unusual grip of the footy, isn't it?
Yeah.
The bowler's got with the left-hand hole on the footy.
Nathan Brown, I think, pioneered that. It's growing in popularity. Fevola kicks his fourth, and the Blues are still thereabouts.
Started by Murphy, towards Fevola.
15 inside 50s this quarter, 15-6. And Fev, if you kick this goal, you are a star.
He was just absolutely poleaxed.
Now, why wasn't that holding the ball? The umpires have had no coherence about their performance today. It was holding the ball. It was an Essendon free kick, and the Essendon players stopped because they believed it was their ball.
Well, Brendan Fevola, incredibly, can put Carlton in front with a straight kick here. They trailed by 48 points deep into the second term. Fevola kicks and goals! The Blues are in front at the MCG, and who would have thought? A dramatic turnaround, and their fans stand and applaud, and Lance Whitnall's played a leading hand.
Scotland scorching it down the southern side. That's a lovely left foot ball. That was a magnificent kick on the end of a long run by Scotland.
Good contact, a magnificent passage of play. The kick was perfect. Mel Michael in big trouble because he will always play from behind, and a leading forward can cut him up. Gives front position away, and when the ball's delivered like that and you've got a bloke with big shoulders and big hands and a big heart, well, you're going to pay a penalty. This could be number 6. He's kicked 5 since late in the second quarter. 3 in this term. Suddenly, he's on fire. And suddenly, the Blues lead by 7 points.
Now, for the Blues. Now, Whitnall is one out. He leads hard and strong and gets it.
For all.
Thank you, boy. Sorry. For all.
Good kick off about 1.5 steps, that one. Now, was this holding the ball? Did he get a handball? The umpire said he got a handball. Maybe he did.
So Brendan Fevola, who was goalless at the 28-minute mark of the second term, has 6 to his name. 2 late in the second quarter, 4 in a wonderful display of full forward play in the third quarter.
He's taken 9 marks inside the 50.
To extend the Carlton lead, and he pins it through.
He's
kicked seven.
Foot. Now Bentick setting it up. Fevola. Fletcher needs to be good. Fevola. He's just got it.
There's marked it. I don't know if you've ever seen a better half of football played by a forward as what we've seen from Brendan Fevola in the third and fourth quarters here at the MCG. One, two, three, four, five goals he's kicked in the second half. Seven for the game.
Bear in mind that he got his first at about this stage of the second quarter.